Hello everyone, this is Somya and you're watching The Global Tales. So today in this video, I am going to share 5 breakfast recipes that I ate for the last week. For me, breakfast is super special because I am on intermittent fasting and the first meal of my day has to be super special because by that time I'm really very hungry. Because I have my last meal at about 7:30 and the next meal at about 12. So yes, I really want my first meal to be tasty, healthy and fulfilling for the entire day. So yes, I'll share 5 of my recipes that I ate for the last week and I hope you'll find it very useful. Try it out for yourself and see how yummy it turns out. So yes, I hope you'll find this video useful. Don't forget to hit the like button if you like this video and do hit the subscribe button and the notification bell. We just turned into 400k family. I'm so happy that we reached this milestone and it is all because of your love, support, your sharing, your liking, your comments. Thank you for doing this for me and keep sharing. Let's make this family as big as possible. Thank you so much for loving me and I really love you all. So yes, let's get into the video. So the first meal that I had in the last week was apple cinnamon oatmeal. It is super tasty and super healthy. For this, you need to heat the pan and add about 1 chopped apple. Apple are a great source of carbohydrates and adds natural sugar to your body and gives the energy that you need for the day to sustain. Then we are going to add about 1/2 lemon. By putting lemon, it will bring out the flavors of the apple and its nutrients to be absorbed in our body. Then we are going to add about 1/2 tablespoon of sugar, again to bring out the properties of apple. 1/4 tablespoon of cinnamon and about 1/4 tablespoon of salt. By adding cinnamon to this dish, we make it very medicinal and loaded with properties like anti-inflammatory and fully loaded with antioxidants. So definitely you should try it out with cinnamon. Then we are going to add about 2 tablespoons of oats. By this time you need to turn off the flame. And then after that we are going to add about 100 ml of milk. And then you are simply going to serve it hot. It's really tasty. The apple comes into your mouth and you feel the flavor and it's really healthy at the same time because of being high in fiber, being high in antioxidants. And yes, this is a breakfast recipe that's quite filling. You can serve it with chopped almonds. And yeah, apple cinnamon oatmeal is ready. For the second day, I had paneer toast. This is one of my favorite and very easy to go recipe. Being a vegetarian, the very limited sources of protein that we have comes out of the milk products. That's why I choose paneer to be one of them. And the recipe to make this paneer toast is really simple. Just add butter to a pan. You can use ghee instead. And then about 50 grams of paneer, well chopped. Mix it well together. Then we are going to add all the Italian seasoning. That's oregano, chili flakes, basil powder. Basically every Italian seasoning that's available, you can mix it here. Then salt and chili powder according to your taste preference. Then we are going to add about 2 to 3 tablespoons of milk. You can use almond milk or coconut milk here and mix it well for about 2 to 3 minutes. And your filling or the topping for the toast is ready. After that, you can use a toasted multigrain bread or a brown bread, like I'm using a brown bread over here. Toast it well and then add this topping that you have made for yourself. and then I'm going to top it with either tomato ketchup or tomato puree. I top it with the tomato puree that's homemade. It's a paste of tomato and garlic together and some chili. It's really tasty, and yes, this is one of my favorite breakfast recipes. Turns out to be really tasty and healthy at the very same time. So now comes again one of my favorite recipes that I had, was potato cake. For this you need to chop tomatoes, capsicum and onion, and then you just need to saute them in about 1/4 tablespoon of butter. Mix them all well, let them steam, add about 1/2 tablespoon of oregano, 1/4 tablespoon of black pepper, then salt and chili powder according to your taste. Let the vegetables steam and your inside filling would be ready. After that, you need to mash and crumble the boiled potatoes, about 2 to 3 boiled potatoes. You have a misconception that potatoes make you fat, and I always say that potatoes only make you fat when you deep fry them and have it like a French fries. Boiled potatoes will never make you fat. They were actually source of good carbohydrates in your body, gives you energy to sustain throughout the day. Now take the baking dish and just need to spread this boiled potato in form of a plate in the baking dish, and then add this filling, and then again cover it with boiled potatoes so it will turn out to be a cake. And then you need to bake it for about 10 minutes on about 170 degree centigrade. After that, when your cake is baked, your potato cake is ready. And I assure you, this is going to be your most favorite breakfast recipes. It's not that difficult to make, and at the very same time, it's very tasty. So some of the filling, you can top it here and enjoy this potato cake to the fullest. So next is French toast. This is the modification of vegetarian version of French toast, and a healthier version as well. So here we take about 2 cups of oatmeal. Actually it's oat flour. Then we are going to add about 1 tablespoon of baking powder, 1/2 tablespoon of sugar, and mix all the dry ingredients together. Then we are going to add about 200 ml of milk. Mix it all well together. Because of the baking powder, you can see that the batter is really puffed up. Then we are going to add about 1 tablespoon of vanilla essence. Mix it all well together, and your batter for the French toast is ready. We are also adding about a pinch of salt to bring out the flavors. Then we are going to soak brown bread or multi-grain bread in this batter. So you need to be a little careful with this one because bread breaks very easily.
After that, you need to use a non-stick pan and about half tablespoon of butter or ghee instead, and then place this soaked bread over here. You can add more batter that we have made for this French toast on the top of it to give it this extra layer. Then bake it and roast it well from both the sides till it turns out this into a beautiful color like this. And yes, now your French toast is ready to eat. It seems a little difficult, but it's very easy to make once you get to do it. And it's a super ready, super tasty and a very filling dish. You can serve it with jam, any fruit jam, and you will love it. Last but not the least is my favorite is chia pudding. Very simple, very ready to go recipe. Just add about 2 tablespoons of chia seeds. You know that chia seeds are really beneficial for your body. They are rich in omega-3 fatty acids. They are highly fibrous and really helps your body to boost the digestion and the metabolic process. So definitely try this recipe out. So 2 tablespoons of chia seeds and then add about 1/2 cup of milk in it. Mix it all well together. You can also add about 1 tablespoon of vanilla essence, like I do, because I really like the taste of vanilla extract. Mix it all well together and keep it in refrigerator for about 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, chia seeds would be soaked in milk. And after that, you need to add about 2-3 tablespoons of oats to make this a little thick and also more fibrous for your breakfast. After that, we are going to mix it all well together. It's little thick by now. Now you need to add it in a jar. One layer of this chia and oats mixed with milk, and then we are going to add about 1 banana. Banana gives it a natural sweetness because definitely we haven't used any sugar in this, so banana will give it a natural sweet taste. And then again we are going to top it with a layer of chia and oats mixed with milk. Then you can just top it with some soaked almonds and dates. So it's super tasty, yummy chia pudding. Try all these 5 recipes out and I assure you that you're gonna love it. It's tasty, healthy, fulfilling, and yes, breakfast and the first meal is obviously very important. It gives you energy for the entire day. So yes, that's about this video. I hope you find it useful. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell, and you'll get notified about all my videos. Bye bye, stay fit, stay happy. I'll see you soon. Bye.